Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today we are going to talk about how to do data blending in Data Studio. So for this I have two data set with me, data set 1 and data set 2. Let's just go through the data set once before creating the blend, right? So in data set 1 I have country name, I have country code, I have total participation from this country, total gold, total silver and total bronze, they have won. So this is an Olympics data basically, right? So we have country, we have code, we have total participation and we have the gold, silver and bronze count. And in our second data set, we have countries and we have people accompanying participants. So for example, in Afghanistan, total number of participants was 15 and if I talk about people accompanying them, they were 5. So basically my responsibility is to combine these two data and provide a graph where I can show how many people came from this country for the participation versus how many people came for accompanying them, right? So basically so that I can get a gist like in which country the people are coming, like the accompanying people are coming more than the participants. This is my target, right? So this is my data 1, this is my data 2. Now let's go to the data studio dashboard and let's create a data blend for this part. This is my dashboard. Okay, so before doing anything, right, we have to add the data source in this. Either I can go and click on data or I can go here, manage added data sources. For example, in this case, I'm going to click manage added data sources. It will give me an option to add a data source. I'll click on it. I'll click on Google Sheets. I'll go to dataset 1 as it's already showing me. Otherwise, you can also click the URL and then you can paste the URL of the data source. So in this case, I'll select dataset 1 and I'll select add. It will take some time. Okay. And okay. Now we have got our dataset 1 in this. Okay. So this is the country name. We have country name column here. And instead of record count, I will drag the total participation. I have the numbers here. Now, my second step is how I can create one more column here in which I can get this column from the other data source, right? The people accompanying the participants. Currently in the Data Studio dashboard, we have total participation and countries. So for this, I'm going to add another data in this. Okay, I'll click this. I'll click on Google Sheets. I'll click on dataset 2. You can also put the URL of the Google Sheet and proceed. In this case, I'm going to select dataset 2 and add it again. So this step will add dataset 2 in the Data Studio memory. Now, what I have to do is, I know that data has been added now, right? Dataset 2 and dataset 1. We can see the data sources as of now. Now how to blend? On the right hand side below the data source, we have an option to blend data, right? I'll go and click on it. And if you're seeing something in this particular page, right? For example, in this page, I am seeing table 1, dataset 1. That means this table is ready to be merged with another table. How? To merge with the another table, I'm going to click this option, join another table. I'll click it. And it will give me the data sources available in the memory of this Data Studio. So in this case, added data sources, we added from the resource section, right? So I'll click on dataset 2 because dataset 1 is already present. I'll click on dataset 2. Perfect. So I have dataset 2, I have dataset 1 and there is a configuration going on in between them. Okay. And I can see that in both the tables, right? In both the tables, we have countries and countries at the top. So basically this is the joining key of this configuration. So with the help of this dimension, with the help of column countries, this data studio will understand the data and will map it accordingly. So the second column which I required was people accompanying participants. I'll click on it and drag it to the metric section. Cool. So my 80% work is done, but a very important step that has to be taken care of when we are moving forward. So I'm going to click on this edit button, configure join. Okay. So in this video, we are going to talk about left outer. So whenever you are merging data, whenever you are joining two data sources, so there are five configurations that you can have. First is left outer. In this video, we are going to talk about left outer, and in my upcoming videos, I'm going to talk about other sections as well. So left outer means the basic mapping will be done as per the left data. Left data means, I'll just save this. Okay. I'll just click save. Left data means this table. So try whenever you are joining two tables, try to keep the maximum data, right? The table which contains maximum data on the left hand side. So for example, in table 1, the total number of countries are 200, and in table 2, the total number of countries are 50. And I know that these 50 countries are already present in table 1. So in that case, table 1 should be on the left because it contains maximum number of countries here, so that the mapping can be done accurately. Right. So that's why we are taking table 1 here and then table 2 this side. After doing this step, I'm going to click on save, and it will give me the dimensions like this. So I'll just delete. I'll just again drag and drop here people accompanying the participants. We have successfully created first data blend in which I needed country as well as I needed total participants, and after that I needed people accompanying those participants, right? So if I want to check the data, I will go and add the summary row here. Okay, the total is 3430 for total participants. I'll go and check in my data source. Total participants total is 3430. It is correct. And if I talk about people accompanying participants, it is 1778. I'll go to the data set 2. I will just check the total, 1778. So that means I have imported complete data from both the data sources in this blended table. And once we get this table, we can convert this into whatever graphs I want. I'll just convert it like this or like this. Yeah, so I can get the ratio as well. So for example, in France, 53 is accompanying 53 participants. In Great Britain, total participants were 53 and total people accompanying the participants were 5. So we can get a ratio accordingly. So this is an example. You can create table, you can create charts, that is your choice. But this is how we do a left outer join and blend the data in Data Studio dashboard. I hope you understood my video. If you have any doubts, please write them in the comments so that I can clear them out. I hope you liked my video. Thank you very much.